In this problem, we want to find the area of the region bounded by y equals x, y equals 1 over x, x equals 0, x equals 2, and y equals negative 1. So that's a lot of functions. So let's start, of course, by just graphing this region so we can get a sense of what we're dealing with. So you could graph this by hand. None of these are too complicated, so that wouldn't be too hard to do. Or you could use a calculator. I'm going to use a computer program to show you what this region looks like. Okay, so the first function that was mentioned was the line y equals x. And then we also have y equals 1 over x, the line x equals 0, which is just the y-axis, the line x equals 2, and the line y equals negative 1. And then I'm looking for the region that's bounded between all five of those functions. So if I just kind of shade in that region, it's right in here. So our goal is to, first of all, just set up the integral that describes the area of this region. So in general, when we're doing this, there's several things that should be on our mind. We need to think about the boundaries of our region. So in this case, which x values span this region? And then we need to think about what function is on top and what function is on bottom. So as far as the x values, this is pretty nicely marked out for us. This region goes between x equals 0 and x equals 2. So that part's not too bad. But let's think about top function, bottom function. Because if you remember, in general, the area of the region between two curves is given by an integral. And we do the integral of the top minus the bottom function. So identifying those functions is a really important step. So let's take a closer look at this region here. So my bottom function is pretty obvious. It's this, what my line in green here is, this y equals negative 1. That's definitely on the bottom of the region. But if I look at what is on the top of the region, there's really two different functions here depending on where I am. It looks from about 0 to 1, the function y equals x is on top, but from 1 to 2, the function 1 over x is on top. So this is pretty common that this kind of thing would happen, and we call this often a compound region. And the way we do this is we simply split our area expression into multiple integrals to account for the top or the bottom function changing. So that's all we're going to have to do in this case. Okay, so first let's just verify this point right here. It looks like it's at 1, but let's just make sure. So this happens when the line y equals x intersects the line y equals 1 over x. So to solve for an intersection point algebraically, we simply take those functions and set them equal to each other. So I'm solving x equals 1 over x. So I can write that as x squared equals 1, which gives me x equals plus or minus 1 as solutions. Okay, so it is 1 like we thought. That point is at x equals 1. Now that point's going to actually be where that x value is going to be where we split up our integral. So let's start setting up our integral. So my first integral is going to be from 0 to 1. From the left bound of the region, which is at x equals 0, to this point where I want to split things up, which is at x equals 1. Now on that interval, I need to think about what is my top function and what is my bottom function. So my top function is the line y equals x, and my bottom function is the line y equals negative 1. So I end up with x minus negative 1, the integral of that with respect to x. Okay, then plus. Now I need my other integral. This one should go from 1 to 2, right? From that intersection point until x equals 2, which is the right bound of my region. And on this interval, the function 1 over x is on top, and then y equals negative 1 is on bottom. So 1 over x minus negative 1 is my integral. So if I clean that up a little, I've got the integral from 0 to 1 of x plus 1 dx plus the integral from 1 to 2 of 1 over x plus 1 dx. So let's go back to the board and actually calculate these integrals. So if I take this first integral, I should get 1 half x squared plus x evaluated from 0 to 1 plus, and then for my second integral, the integral of 1 over x, or the antiderivative of 1 over x, is the natural log of the absolute value of x, and then plus x evaluated from 1 to 2. So now I start evaluating. So my first integral here, if I plug in 1, looks like I should get 1 half plus 1, and then minus, plug in 0, and I just get 0. And then for my second expression here, if I plug in 2, I get natural log of 2 plus 2, minus plug in 1 gives me natural log of 1 plus 1. So let's work this out. So 1 half plus 1 is 3 halves. And then I've got some zeros, and then plus natural log of 2, plus 2, minus natural log of 1, but that's just 0, and then minus 1. So it looks like in the end I should get 5 halves plus the natural log of 2. And that gives me the area of my compound region. So basically the only new thing we did here is we just had to split up that region into multiple integrals, and the way we split that up was just based on where that top function changed. Sometimes it could happen that you would have to do it maybe based on where the bottom function changes. But that's a general idea for evaluating the area of these compound regions.